Hey, it is your buddy Peace and Harmony with you here today. Much love going out to the Empowered Harmonizers, and a big, huge thank you to those of you who have wished me a speedy recovery after my procedure. Thank you so much. We're zooming in and we're diving into a great viewer question and comment was that was regarding a relationship that she had ongoing with a covert narcissist, how she tried to be perfect. She did everything perfectly for this person. She worked up and down, right and left, did everything to take care of and be there at the drop of a feather for this individual. I mean, in other words, nothing could have been more perfect. She had done everything impeccably, making his dinners, being there to go out on dates, doing what he wanted, being on time. I mean, all the things that are the makings of a great relationship. Being fair, being giving, being very, very affectionate to this person. Yet they were eventually devalued and discarded out of the relationship, and essentially they did nothing wrong. And it's really hard for her to comprehend and metabolize this experience, and physiologically, she's feeling very down and shut down and doesn't know which way is up. Don't know, doesn't know which way is north, doesn't know why this happened, and furthermore, is afraid to really kind of make a move or begin relating to others, let alone to herself, because she had invested so much time and energy in giving, love energy to this person, and she feels extremely deflated, and just really devalued out of this whole situation, and is wondering what it is she could have done wrong. And I want to express to you those people who have felt like you have done everything you possibly could, stuck your neck out for this person, went above and beyond, were a great caregiver, a great lover, a great friend, a great confidant, a great spouse, a great colleague. And this happens in all sorts of different formatting situations. Basically, it is the perfectionist model that the narcissist holds to the yardstick. Stick the measuring stick to others who they're in relationship with. In other words, if you don't make me look good, then to the curb you go. And it doesn't even have to matter of you have not done anything to make them look bad. It's just that they have these very perfectionist models of those who they will relate to. And in fact, they're more the perfectionist expectation actually destroys any essentially worthwhile relationship that they could have. In other words, that it's just so perfectionistic, the standards that they hold their mate to, their spouse, their coworker, whatever it is, the dynamic of the relationship is just, it is not able to be reached by anybody. Their standards are way too high. And it destroys any valuable relationship that could be substantive to them and for them. Really, the best thing that could have come along for them since sliced bread could have been you, yet they did not have the filters. They were not open. They have such perfectionist models for which of relating to that even they end up pushing away those people who would be excellent for them in their lives. And then what ends up happening is that then that inner critic ends up becoming internalized and feeling like there is something wrong with you. And I'll have you know there's nothing wrong with you. You did nothing wrong. You did everything that you wanted or wanted to give, or even more than you over obligated yourself in wanting to give, yet it just did not work out. It has nothing to do with you. It is everything to do with the perfectionist projection that they have onto others and the high standards with which they hold all others to, which oftentimes, excuse me, are impossible to achieve or maintain. It's not realistic. And that this is furthermore, basically part of their pathology is that they have such a entitlement aspect to them that they will just, churn through relationships and just take, and yet it's really they're the one who have the lack of respect, the lack of being able to relate to others. It's not that you did not have the ability to relate. they do not have the ability to relate to others in these important ways, which is to be easygoing, spontaneous, fun. I mean, we talk about all the positive role models of relationships, but furthermore, it's to understand that, oftentimes in healthy relationships, you don't need the other to be perfect. Most people who are empathetic, in fact, they tend to like people who are glaringly imperfect because they know that that's the human condition and they don't have a big hang up on others having to be perfect or, them being perfect themselves. In other words, they're able to let go those stressful goals or aspirations or levels to a relationship. They don't like to live the unrealistic. They don't like to live the lie. They don't like that sort of pressure on an ongoing basis. In fact, that could have been one of the most desirable aspects about you is that the narcissist didn't feel that they had to impress you. They could let their hair down, take their shoes off, be relaxed. Yet for them, that's just a temporary respite. It's a temporary oasis. They have no, they have no intention of committing, yet they might put on or pretend a mask to be as such in a committed relationship. And it's very heartbreaking. It's very devastating. It brings out the worst in you to feel like you have been rejected, and abandoned when you did your best. You're like, this is the best a person can be, and this is not good enough. Are you kidding me? I mean, it makes you shocked, but it makes you really think because the esteem with which you held the narcissist in your mind's eye, that person became like the penultimate person with which you derived your level of approval. In other words, if it met their approval, then you were doing great. So a lot of people tend to subconsciously equate that, and in their processing that, if it's good enough for them, then that's the best I can be, when it really should be your own internal standard. When we talk about the internal locus of control, you should always be looking, engaging on yourself and not checking in with others. In other words, is this good enough for them? Or will they like this? All those stress hormones, which are very pressurizing and lead you to the hyperadrenalized state, the armoring, where your muscles are so tense, the feeling of being, trying to always be perfect, always running, exhausting yourself, as if, if you're not exhausting yourself and over-obligating, that love is, you don't love me. In other words, if you haven't done this to the penultimate degree, it's not good enough. So, even though and that can oftentimes be a positive in the course of a relationship with someone who is codependent and a narcissist, because the codependent feels like, well, they're bringing out the best in me. I'm being my best. I'm working these long hours. I'm, becoming perfect for them. I'm doing different things that otherwise I would not have done. So then the self-justification takes place where you feel like, well, maybe this is really stretching my boundaries. This is really stretching my horizon. So then you tend to positively make rationalizations for why it is that you're suffering, and then furthermore, in the healing process, to be able to come depressurized, decompressed, and not be just with your armor on, take your armor off, stop trying to be so perfect, so one way, and it's usually for just one person, when you really, your internal guide should be yourself. In other words, is this how I want to be? Is this how I want to feel in a relationship? Is this my boundary? Is this my standard? It shouldn't have to be to match another's. You should have it internally calculated in what you want. And really, that's a state of maturing and meeting developmental stages in relationships successfully. And it's knowing that you have this awareness that others don't have to be perfect. That's not what you're looking for. And certainly, you don't have to always be perfect. That's too much pressure. The pressure then leads to the hyperadrenalized state and then the pathological lying to others or oneself that I can do this, I can do this, I can do this. And you end up violating your boundaries because of that, hyper aroused adrenalized state. And then the stress hormones really are what cause, the pathological lying or putting on of the mask, so to speak, and not being true to yourself. A lot of people say, well, I just want to be authentic. Well, there you go. You just have to de-stress Do not constantly feel like you have to meet another's level of approval. It has to be within yourself. It has to be, if it's good enough for you, it should be good enough for others. Yeah, if someone's like, hey, yeah, you haven't gone to see the movies in 5 years, it's time to get a life. If you agree, hey, yeah, maybe I would like to go out and do some more things, then this can help. And this is what we call, relationship enhancement. One enhances the other. So there can be, positive, pushing and pulling in relationships. I mean, that's what relationships are. It's about, enhancing your life and being, and having that individuation, they'll come together and the two, one complements the other rather than feeling less than. And that oftentimes is the assessment that comes, after a developing or discarding relationship with a narcissist. But realize, you can do it. You can let go this pressure. You can let go this perfectionist need. You don't need to be perfectly social for yourself to either get into relations. The relationships you might need now might be therapeutic in nature, meaning more religious, spiritual, books, podcasts, videos, spiritual counselors, therapists, doctors. I mean, more therapeutic relationships. But eventually, once you begin to heal with time, then you'll be able to expand that onto then, once you have that self-trust, then people who I know that I can be attracted to and trust at the same time. So don't hang on to that pressure. You can do it. Let go of the pressure, the outside judging. It's, being in a relationship doesn't mean you have to people please. That is an erroneous tenet that you might have then indoctrinated or felt was necessary for yourself to be in relationships. Let go that standard. Let go that imperfectionist model and realize you are good enough. It is up to you. You can be happy just as you are and realize that people will also accept and love you just as you are. You just got to give it a chance. It is your buddy, Peace and Harmony, with you here today, and I hope that these videos do help. Please share and please subscribe for more great tools, videos, discussion, and support.